Avengers Assemble. Those words were the thing that every Marvel fan wanted to hear when the Marvel Cinematic Universe was born. And they dragged out how long we had to wait to hear it. But we got it in Avengers Endgame in 2019. What came of that movie was a lot, including a large number of shifts in the balance of power within the MCU itself. To the extent that, as of yet, there isn't a confirmed date or even possible year that a fifth Avengers movie could come. But what might help influence that? Allow us to show you Avengers 5 what we know. Number 5, the current state of the MCU. So before we look to the future, we need to look at the past and the present and understand just how far and yet how little we've come in recent years. 2019, which now seems like an eternity ago, was a major year for Marvel in all the ways that mattered. Avengers Endgame came out and shattered all sorts of box office records. And that was followed by Spider-Man Far From Home, and that too was a major box office hit, as well as the end of Phase 3. Phase 4 was set to start in 2020, with the solo Black Widow movie and the Eternals, and then lead to many other things. But then 2020 actually happened and everything got shifted. And it's still being shifted, believe it or not. And as if that wasn't enough, Disney Plus was hoping to release some of their Marvel shows on the streaming service in that year, but obviously that didn't happen. 2021 has helped recover a lot of the momentum as well. Disney Plus has reigned supreme with WandaVision, Falcon and the Winter Soldier, Loki, What If, and the upcoming Hawkeye series, all continuing things in their own way and setting up Phase 4 in major ways. In theaters and Disney Plus, you had Black Widow, Shang-Chi, and Eternals, and they've all had solid box office results. 2022 had another shift in release dates, but we'll see how it goes. Oh, and Spider-Man No Way Home is the most hyped thing since Endgame, so there's that. Given all of these delays and shifts in goals though, you do have to wonder who would be in Avengers 5, whenever and if it ever comes out. Because if you recall, the roster isn't what it used to be in terms of who is around to assemble. Number 4, the roster. The first 20 plus Avengers movies was very much about bringing together the core Avengers roster and then growing it until we reach the events of Avengers Endgame. And by the end of Endgame, say that one 5 times fast, we have ourselves a little bit of a situation with the roster. Iron Man and Black Widow are dead, as is Vision via Infinity War, technically. Steve Rogers is old and has passed the shield down to Sam Wilson, aka the Falcon. Hawkeye is retired, well, kind of, he's training someone. Scarlet Witch is, well, we won't spoil WandaVision. Hulk is potentially crippled due to using the Infinity Gauntlet. He will be in She-Hulk, though, and so on and so forth. In short, there's a lot of questions about the roster for Avengers now that Endgame is over and lots of characters' fates are either decided or questionable. That also doesn't take into effect things like the new characters joining the MCU, like the Eternals and Shang-Chi, who was basically drafted into the Avengers at the end of his film. So there are a lot of question marks. What's more, the person who is very clearly going to be the new leader of the Avengers is no longer with us in real life. Number 3, Black Panther. The loss of Chadwick Boseman is something that many are still dealing with, and the fallout of his death is still being felt in the MCU as a whole. Black Panther 2 is still happening, but also there is a World of Wakanda series coming to Disney Plus via the director of the films. So that part of the MCU isn't going anywhere. But the question is, how will the Avengers be affected by Black Panther's death and the knowledge that he won't be replaced by another actor? Now, technically speaking, Black Panther wasn't drafted into the Avengers until Infinity War, as Civil War was something else entirely. And just as important, he's only fought with the Avengers in a capacity to where he was a warrior and not a leader. In the comics, Black Panther has not just been on the Avengers, he's been their leader. In fact, he is currently the leader of the Avengers right now. After the events of Endgame, both Captain America and Iron Man are either out of the Avengers or dead. Thus, a massive hole would have been open for T'Challa to come in and take leadership of the Avengers in their absence, giving him the much-deserved time to interact with other Avengers and show a different side of T'Challa that we hadn't seen before. But now, that's not an option. And while Shuri would make a great Black Panther, it wouldn't really make sense for her to be the leader of the Avengers just yet. Captain Marvel could fill the role and Shuri could still be part of the Avengers whenever they reassemble, but no doubt there was a plan for Black Panther, T'Challa, to lead, and now that's gone. But again, this places doubts on who will be in the Avengers and how it'll be received when this new roster reforms. And that's not to say that others won't leave before the fifth Avengers movie arrives. And then, obviously, you have to ask who the Avengers would fight. Number 2, potential villains. Through the first four Avengers films, these Earth's mightiest heroes would have had to face a lot of threats. First, it was Loki and the Chitauri at Thanos' orders. Then, it was Ultron. And after that, it was a two-part battle with Thanos in Infinity War and Endgame. But who will take the villain mantle now that many of the heavy hitters, if you will, are gone? Well, there are options out there, some of which have already been teased. Easily, one of the biggest ones is Dormammu, the main arch-villain of Stephen Strange. He is an incredible magical threat and someone that was shown in the first Doctor Strange movie, but only in an incorporeal form. We haven't seen him much like his comic book self as of yet. As such, he could be a huge threat. Elsewhere, there is Kang the Conqueror, who is very much present in the MCU right now via Loki and the upcoming Ant-Man Quantumania. Who thought that was a good title? We know that Kang will be present to fight certain characters, but will he bring the Avengers back together? That, we don't know. Another player in this game could be the Celestials, who had a huge presence in the recent Eternals film. Even having two of them on Earth in various capacities, hey, no spoilers here, the Avengers would no doubt know of their presence now, so maybe that will unite them. Phase 4 is still very much on its early legs, and we don't know how long it'll go due to all the shows and movies that are potentially going to be tied to it. But given all the chaos and instability that's going on, you do need to ask. Number 1. Do we really need a fifth Avengers movie? At first, this may seem like a blasphemous statement, but we promise there is a reason for asking this question. Mainly, the first three phases very much had an overarching plan. Everything was meant to lead up to Avengers Endgame, to Thanos, to the Infinity Gauntlet, and thus change the Marvel Universe forever. However, now that plan is done. It's finished. And now it's the question of what's next. And right now, the plan, if you will, is to build up the rest of the Marvel Universe. Captain Marvel, Doctor Strange, and more may be getting sequels, but we're also getting debuts like with Shang-Chi, The Eternals, and more are coming. There's a lot of new stories to tell, and while many fans are going to want to see an Avengers 5 eventually, that doesn't mean it has to be done soon. Because right now, the MCU is in such a state and has such a roster that it honestly doesn't need an Avengers movie, because of all the stories they're telling in movies and on things like Disney+. Kevin Feige has not teased a year for Avengers 5, and for good reason. There's still a lot to build up to, and that means there's a lot to wait on. And so when they do assemble, it'll be worth it again. So, what do you think? What do you think of this look at the fifth Avengers movie, and what is possible to happen? Who might lead the charge going forward, and what else might occur to prevent the Avengers from assembling once again? Do you hope there's another Avengers movie sooner rather than later? Or do you think the MCU needs to stabilize in a big way before that happens? Let us know in the comments below, and we'll see you next time on the channel.